let's jump back in. So, very quick review. These reviews become shorter and shorter. If you don't know this video series, then please go into the playlist and go back. Otherwise, you will have no clue what we're doing here. So we imported our model, a mesh model. It can be, it doesn't have to be a mesh model. It can be a NURBS model, but it would be translated to a mesh in any case. And we create the butterfly geometry, a wind tunnel. We modified the wind tunnel to fit our needs. In that case, we also divided it in smaller cells. That's important to actually do the calculation. And in the third step, we calculate the snappy hex mesh. And for this, to show you the data in Paraview, I ran a much more detailed analysis with a very high refinement level. So it took much longer, took about 2 hours to run with about 500 iterations. We talked about iterations in the last video, and I could let it run for longer, but we iterated 500 times to try to minimize the residual values to a point where we can say that our simulation is very, very accurate. Not to confuse simulation with the real world. This is something different, as I said already last time. And we plotted this graph, which actually shows us on how the residual values are coming down. And the calculation gets finer and finer and finer. Yeah, here we, in the past, we did some visualization of the data, of the vectors, and also of the the wind pressure. I will not go more into detail. So what happens when we run this in here, we can always show like a limited amount of data really, or can visualize very limited amount of stuff. I mean, it's great. It's also great for later print it or visualize it. It's nice, but it's not all what's actually in the simulation or in the data we created. So that's important to understand. These values on the probes are only a fraction of the information we have created. So what actually happens? So if we look into here, into the report of the solution, we see that OpenFOAM wrote something into this folder. The user admin butterfly toy plane case 19. Case 19 was the case 19 here, the name I gave it to rerun the last simulation. So if we go now into that folder, so now you can see that we ran all these different cases, and we started here with toy plane case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And this was the last one. It also, it's important to know that it always keeps all the data. So if you run out of space, and these files are huge, they are huge. If you look at here, the case 18 was actually 5 gigabytes big. So be careful. We can actually delete all these. Now, if we go into that folder, we see it actually created for each iteration its separate folder, and all the data it created, it's in here in these files. And it not just created the vector, the wind speed, but also all the other possible fields like pressure and so on. I don't even know what they all are, and I hopefully will go there at some point. But yeah, for each iteration it created these values. That case must be huge. If I go here and look at it, it's 60 gigabyte. So yeah, again, just keep that in mind. Now at the end here, you can see there is an OpenFOAM file. OpenFOAM case file. It has 0 kilobyte, but we'll see that it's not true. It's actually, there is actually something in there, but, or let's say it will then look at these data here, whatever is in here. So let's open Paraview that came with your Blue Core installation. All right, now, so in order to open Paraview, we just need to type it here in the search bar. Or you go into the folder and open the file, and it, normally that also works. I like this way. And then I can navigate to the file, butterfly, and this was the toy plane case 19. And you can see it created for each iteration its own folder. And at the lower end is the toy plane case foam file. So that's the file we can open with Paraview. And then nothing happens, really. We need to apply that kind of layer. So how it works, and again, this won't be like a tutorial for Paraview, but just so you get the understanding of that there is way more behind this Butterfly CFD analysis, or Eddy 3D, the other plugin. Both use the same engine in the background. Now, it's loaded, it seems like it works, but we can't see anything. Here's a button that says apply, and that's what we need to do. Now we see our wind tunnel, and I will just show you one of the ways we can actually look at our data. This is not very useful, of course, but we could, for example, change here. I can change the opacity of that thing, and that actually shows us our model inside the wind tunnel. Also not very useful at the moment, but you will see right away that this can be really cool. So there are different ways in how we can build additional layers on top of this and to look at different things. So for example, we can create a contour layer. Never tried that before. We can apply a clipping plane to slice through the whole thing. What for me it's, and what I'm gonna show now is what I really like to do is to show the stream. Yeah, it's all a bit hard to navigate. The left mouse click rotates the model, but it rotates it in a weird way. If you use the shift, then you can rotate the viewport like that. And if you don't press shift, then it's more like this, but it always weirdly rotates that whole thing. Now, if we want to turn on the stream tracker, we can adjust this diagonal, which basically where the software tries to or show the stream going through. For example, if we want to see a vertical plane sliced, then we need to adjust it in a way that this fits. What we could do, we could look at from the top, adjust this here and here, and then from the side. There are other ways to navigate that. You can also put the coordinates as well, or you use these buttons here. It's all a bit interesting. You want to see a bit more, so that's why I trim it like this. And now if we apply that, we get this. It's actually a mesh. It shows us and how the air flows around the object. Pretty cool. By the way, the wheel also allows, if the wheel is pressed on the mouse button, then you can pan the thing. You can also try to adjust it here. So if we want to have a perfect horizontal plane cut, then we can cut it here with, let's say if this is 5, we can keep it at 5, the set position. And then also here, this is a set position, or maybe 6, or maybe 5.5. It's very hard to navigate, I have to say. If you're used to Rhino navigation, then this is a bit annoying. And you can see it's relatively simple to update. I think it's pretty cool. let's keep it like that. So yeah, play around. There is a lot of other things to explore. There are really good tutorials online. I saw this guy, let's check, Cyprian Russo, this guy. He has a whole playlist just for the Paraview, the interface and what you can do with it and so on. So I recommend to watch that if you want to get more into that. Yeah, so with that we conclude the toy plane video series, and we will not stop here with the CFD, with Butterfly CFD, because there are other things to look at. For example, heat transfer, indoor airflow, and so on. I still need to look into it to better understand what and how we and how it works. But there will be definitely follow-up videos. Watch the space, stay tuned, and let me know if any question. And sign up, become a member, support me, or write good comments. That's also good. So, also supports me. So anything where we can work together, perfect. All right, see you next time.